Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, madam.
Myself, Dr. Nisha Vikaswarani from Shankarlal Khandelwal College, Akola. And I'm here to present on agriculture, entrepreneurship development among the stakeholder farmers and students of Akola. Now, what is apiculture? Apiculture, it is actually the scientific and artificial rearing of honeybees for the production of honey and the other byproducts. Actually, it is an agro-based industry and it is eco-friendly in nature and it conserves the biodiversity. Honeybees, they basically belong to phylum Arthropoda and the genus is Apis. The bees belonging to genus Apis, they are truly known as honeybees, and other than honeybees, other bees are also producing the honey, but in apiculture, we usually rear the two bees, that is Indian hivebee, that is Apis serrana indica and Apis mellifera, because they are very friendly in nature. And other than this, Apis dorsata is also seen to produce honey and Apis floria is also there. There are different castes of honeybees. The first is, the polymorphism is seen in honeybees. There are three castes. The first is known as queen, the second is known as worker, and the third are known as drones. The queen, there is only one queen in a hive, and there are around about 60,000 to 70,000 worker bees, and there are around about 500 to 700 drones. Actually, apiculture, it promotes pollination. It is the need of the day, because agriculture, we need to increase the crop productivity, and this apiculture, it helps in pollination. The bees, they help in pollination. Apart from pollination, the other byproducts of apiculture are the propolis, the honey, the brood, the venom, bee venom, etc. We'll see the importance of one by one. The honey, it is used in the traditional medicine and also in the modern medicine. It is actually a sweet, viscous edible fluid, and it is very energetic drink, and it has got many different importance, and that is antimicrobial activity, anti-inflammatory activity. It is used as anti-diabetic agent. It is anti-cancerous. Like cardiovascular diseases, it can reduce the cardiovascular diseases also. The second byproduct of apiculture is beeswax. Beeswax is also very important. It is used in cosmetic industries. It is used for candle preparation and for wood polishes, for carbon paper making, etc. Bee pollen, it is a very proteinaceous diet which is used nowadays for the children's. It has got very good amount of vitamins and minerals. It is antiviral and antibacterial in nature, and that's why it is used for the children's. The next product is royal jelly. Royal jelly is a white viscous fluid or substance which is produced by the bees, and this has got a very distinctive feature. It increases the fertility of the female bee, and it also increases the lifespan of the female bee. It prevents the aging process of female. That's why this royal jelly, it is also, it is nowadays used in cosmetics and in modern medicine. The next is propolis. It is nothing but the resin plus the enzymes plus pollen. It is mixed and it is used for sealing the honey combs. And it is antibacterial, antiviral and antifungal in nature. Mead, it is an alcoholic drink which is prepared from the honey. Bee venom, it is again very useful. Bee venom therapy, it is nowadays used to cure or to subsidize the effect of arthritis, or it is anti-inflammatory in nature, and bee venom is very costly actually. It contains melatonin, adolphin, which acts as anti-inflammatory and anti-analgesic. It is analgesic, sorry. the cost of different byproducts are like honey. It is available in market from 600 to 800 per kg. Bee wax it is around about 650 per kg. Propolis 6500 per kg. This is the minimum limit it can raise. Royal jelly it is around about 150,000 per kg, because it is not required in kgs. Actually, it is sold in grams, but I have written it in kg. Bee venom, it is again very costly, 300 per gram. The global scenario of honey production, India ranked around about 6th in globally, but we can see the percentages. India is producing only 4.6% of honey, which is exported, while the China it is exporting 24.2%. Though we are on sixth position, then also the difference is very high. We have to go up to that limit. In India, if we see, Delhi produces around about 75% of honey. It is not actually Delhi; it is the states nearer to Delhi. Delhi, Rajasthan it produces 11%, Maharashtra it is producing only 5.14% of the total honey which has been exported. So again we have to increase our production, and that's why apiculture is very much in need. These are some tools which are required for apiculture. And thank you.